A lot of times students have this very common query about what role they should be playing sitting in a JD. Roles like aggressor, roles like meditator, roles like idea generator, roles like a good listener. So time and again we come across people asking such questions. So in this particular video I'll be answering this query. Now, the kind of role that a candidate can play in a JD definitely depends on the kind of personality he or she is. And another variable that governs these roles is the demand in the group discussion of that particular role. So, taking into account these two variables, I'm discussing the very first role, that is the role of an aggressor or the role of a person who speaks a lot. Now, of course, aggression is required in a JD, but then to a certain level, you really cannot cross that red line wherein you're getting so much aggressive that you're not giving chances to people to speak. Cutting people, raising your voices unnecessarily, getting into unnecessary arguments with people around, obviously, is a sign of an extreme aggression. But keeping your point forward with an assertive tone that may be aggressive for a few people can be taken. So aggression, of course, is a good thing, but in certain limits. Number two is speaking less. Now, of course, there will be lots many people who by their natural selves speak less. So it becomes very difficult for them to speak a lot or to speak aggressively in a JD. So these people, of course, can take advantage of this personality trait of theirs because speaking less can definitely be compensated by two things. Number one, people who speak less, of course, can write down the points of the people around and can analyze the group discussion in a better way and can put forward their analysis of what the group is doing gain a lot of brownie points through that. Number two is people who speaking less, of course, can concentrate on delivering some quality points because they have more time to think about what they really need to say. Point number three would be the role of a meditator. Of course, yes, everybody really cannot do this because it comes naturally to a few people. Now, of course, you should play the role of a meditator if you really feel that particular thing is required. In terms of when the JD is really getting out of control or people are unnecessarily arguing with each other. So in this situation, if you try to get into that argument, try to become a meditator, of course, obviously you'll get a lot of points. And the last thing is idea generator, or we also call it as a professor or let's say researcher. So idea generation obviously is a very, very important thing. When the JD is stuck, obviously a person who can come up with a new idea, of course, will get a lot of points. But the thing is, should a particular person stick to one particular role all the time? Let's say you are only generating ideas in the JD, you're only trying to meditate, become a meditator in the JD, or maybe you're only trying to listen to what people are saying and giving them an analysis. Of course, the answer will be no. So a perfect candidate will be somebody who can perform all these roles. So you have to come out of your natural selves and practice it out so that you can play these different roles at different points of times in a JD.